This is a blight on the community.
Why do we have to look at this?
Cape Coral neighbors are fed up about living beside a concrete shell for the past 2 years. It's the construction zone that just won't end, an eyesore they're tired of.
The NBC2 investigators first showed you this house on Northwest 19th Place at the end of the year. At that point, the project had already been going on for 21 months. Investigator Rachel Polanski is back in the newsroom. Rachel, has there been any work done since then?
Peter, it certainly does not look that way to my untrained eye. In December, builder Daniel Ramiro blamed the construction delays on issues with investors. Now he tells me he's working things out with the city, but planning on continuing construction over the next few weeks.
Like many retirees,
we all moved in here thinking that we'd own a little small piece of paradise.
Jim Leatherman and his wife moved to Cape Coral for the palm trees and the sunshine.
We purchased this home in December 3 years ago.
And they were happy. At first,
Jim Leatherman spends a lot of time working on motorcycles in his garage. But for the last 2 years, this has been his view, a concrete shell that he calls an eyesore.
I'm paying high property taxes to live next door to this. I don't think that's fair to me, and it's not fair to my neighbors. It's been like this for 2 years.
He's right. A quick property search reveals that the building permit was issued here in March 2017. So what's the deal? When I questioned Cape Coral City spokeswoman Connie Barron in December, she said that code has opened 2 new code cases against the builder, Daniel Ramiro, and the city was pressing forward with the magistrate process. By phone on Friday, Ramiro told me that he got the go-ahead to resume construction last week, and he said he'll start work again once new trusses are delivered. In the meantime,
and now you see what happened.
I showed the property to home builder Matt St. Clair, the former president of the Cape Coral Construction Industry Association.
2 years, definitely there's something wrong in that aspect.
And beyond the length of time it's taken, he has other concerns.
Well, I'm in astonishment. You know, most people that do a slab before they lay the block, they usually do a saw cut. There hasn't been any saw cuts in there at all.
So what does all this mean in layman's terms?
Poor workmanship, poor supervision.
And ongoing frustration for the neighbors forced to live in a constant construction zone.
I'm disappointed in this city because the city's projecting itself as this beautiful place to come and retire to, which is why we did. Yet the city does nothing about blights like this.
Now I've asked Cape Coral's assistant city manager where the city stands on these code complaints and what its next steps will be. I'm still waiting for those answers. For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Rachel Polanski.